我们信了主耶稣以后
after we have believed in Christ,
那主耶稣啊，就要赏赐给我们各样的恩典。
God will grant us many blessings.
啊，这个恩典呢，就是从属灵的开始。
And these blessings are the beginning of our spiritual journey.
那主耶稣恩典就是让我们能够离开罪恶。
Because these blessings are so that we may depart from sin.
那改变我们的思想观念。
And to change our thoughts and mentality.
让我们能够活得更有自信。
So that we can live an orderly life.
让我们活得更有尊严
so that we can live with dignity.
让我们活得更有平安，更有喜乐
so that we can live with peace and joy.
所以我们现在就要来回想主耶稣的恩典
so now let us recount the blessings of God.
那以前作诗的人啊，他也是在回想神的恩典
and the psalmists of the past, they were also recounting the blessings from God.
那因为人是有感情的，是有血肉的
becauseMen are of flesh. It is one with emotions.
所以只要人感受到对方给我们的恩典
as men, once we feel the blessings, the mercies that other people have given us,
那一个正常的人就想要怎么来回报
a normal person would think, how can I repay their love?
因为人是有感情的动物啊
because as men, we are creatures of emotion.
所以作诗的人也是一样
so the psalmists also were like this.
我们请看诗篇一百十六篇。
Let's turn to Psalm number 116.
诗篇一百十六篇，圣经中间啊，诗篇一百十六篇。
Psalm 116 in the middle of the Bible.
十二节。
Verse 12.
诗篇一百十六篇的十二节。
Psalm number 116, verse 12.
我拿什么报答主向我所赐的一切厚恩？
What shall I render to the Lord for all his benefits towards me?
这边作诗的人他说要拿什么报答来向神所赐给的厚恩是厚厚的恩典 不只是一点点而已、啊、
And here the psalmist says, What shall I render to the Lord for all his benefits towards me? It's not just a little benefit, but all his benefits.
这个恩典呢可能是让作者觉得担当不起、啊、他也没有什么特别的为什么领受神而来的那么多的恩典
and this benefit could be for what the psalmist thought something that he was undeserving and unworthy of that he could not bear it
啊，这个厚厚的恩典呢，是让他一生啊享受不尽的
and all these benefits are more than enough for him to enjoy in his lifetime
那他在这里交代我们说到底是神给他什么样的恩典
so here he declared what are all the benefits He has been given.
所以我们要想想说神啊到底给我们什么样的恩典
So we need to think, what has God given us in our lives?
因为有时候我们对神的恩典啊只是一个很表面的认识
Because many times in our lives, we only have a very shallow understanding of God's blessings.
那我们来看看到底是怎么样的恩典
So let us look at what type of benefits and blessings it is.
他说是116篇的第一节
And let's read Psalm number 116, verse 1.
我爱神、啊、因他听了我的声音和我的恳求。
I love the Lord because he has heard my voice and my supplications.
说神啊，听我们的声音，这是一个极大的恩典呢、啊。
For God to listen to our voice, to hear our voice, it is a tremendous blessing.
啊，讲话有人听啊，完了我们就高兴呢、啊。
When someone listens when we speak, we are joyful.
啊，有些时候我们讲话没人要听啊。
Because many times when we have something to say, nobody wants to listen.
你看我们讲话有些时候孩子也不听啊。
Just consider, when, sometimes when we say things, our kids don't want to listen to us.
我们说话这个配偶可能也不听的。
And even when we speak to our spouse, they may not want to talk to us, listen to us.
那可能父母亲也不会听。
Or sometimes our parents would not listen to us.
那我们的朋友也不听。
And our friends would not want to listen.
同事也不想听。
Nor would our coworkers.
我们老板也不会听。
And so are our bosses.
所以有话讲不出去的。
So even though we have something to say, nobody wants to. We can't speak it out.
因为讲了没人要听啊。
Because even if we say so, nobody would listen to us.
因此有些时候我们就觉得很伤心。
So many times we are very sad.
因为讲话没人听啊。
Because when we say things, nobody wants to listen.
但是呢，假如讲话有人听。
But if we say something and someone is there to listen,
那第一个我们会有什么感觉呢
First of all, how would we feel?
我们觉得我们受尊重。
We would feel that we are respected.
就是因为你尊重我，你才会听我的。
It's because you respect me, you will listen to what I have to say.
啊，不管我讲的有没有道理。
Even regardless of whether what I say has any reason for it.
啊，第一个你愿意听啊。
First of all, you are willing to listen to us.
所以一个人能够被听他的声音，能够被听到。
So a person, their voice can be heard.
啊，他这个人觉得就很有自信，很有自尊。
And this person will feel confident and have dignity.
啊，同时是这个听的人对我说话的人的一种鼓励。
And it's a form of encouragement for the person who listens to the speaker.
那神能够听我们的声音呢，更是不得了啊。
So it is even more tremendous that God is willing to listen to us.
为什么呢？因为第二节说，他既向我侧耳，我一生要求告他。
Why? In verse 2 it says, because he has inclined his ears to me, therefore I will call upon him as long as I live.
啊，既然神会听的话，那他就继续再告诉他。
Since God is willing to listen to us, we will continue to talk to him.
那假如说神不听的话，那他就不说啊。
But if God does not listen, then he will not say.
人家说了也没用。
Because even if he says things, it is useless.
但就神听他的声音呢。
But God is hearing, has heard his voice.
那听神听我们的声音呢、啊，跟人一般的人听我们的声音是不一样的。
For God to hear our voice is different from how other people can hear our voice.
那神听到我们的声音的话，他会有动作。
Because when God hears our voice, He will take action.
他会对我们的请求的一种反应。
And He will respond to our requests.
来，我们看圣经哈。
Let's turn to the
创世纪。
Genesis.
创世纪十六章。
Genesis chapter 16.
创世纪十六章
，Genesis chapter 16,
第七节
，verse 7。
创世纪十六章第七节
，Genesis chapter 16, verse 7。
说神的使者啊，在旷野苏罗的路上水泉旁边啊，遇见谁呢？遇见了夏甲啊，第八节
，verse 8。
对着他说啊，撒勒的使女夏甲，你从哪里来？要往哪里去呢？夏甲就回答说了，我从我的主人的妻子祖母啊撒来面前逃跑出来。第九节
，verse nine。
那主的使者就对他说啊，你回到你的祖母啊，主人的妻子那里，伏在他的手下。第十节
，verse ten。
又说啊，我必使你的后裔极其繁多，甚至不可胜数。十一节
，eleven。
并说啊，你如今怀孕要生一个儿子。可以给他起名叫以实玛利，因为神听了你的苦情。十二节
，twelve，
他为人啊，必像野驴，他的手要攻打人，人的手也要攻打他，他必住在众弟兄的东边。十三节
，thirteen，
那夏甲就称呼那对他说话的神啊为看顾人的神，因而说啊，在这里我也看见那看顾我的神吗？那这夏甲本来。啊，他是居于弱势啊，啊，他就受到他主人的欺负，他想要逃跑。
And Hagar, she was of the weaker party, so she was being mistreated by her mistress, so she fled.
啊，现在跑了以后啊，他自己一个人，那时候他怀孕呢。
But at that time she was pregnant.
啊，孤孤单单一个人。
And she was alone by herself.
没有说话的对象啊
，and there's nobody to talk to。
没有诉苦的对象
，there's nobody to pour out her heart to。
自己很伤心的离开了他的主人的家。
She departed her master's house in sorrow。
孤单啊，是很痛苦的一件事情呢、啊。
It's very terrible to be alone。
没有人愿意孤单呢、啊。
Nobody wants to be alone。
我也不愿意孤单呢、啊。
And even for myself, I don't want to be alone。
所以我的太太赶快来了，要来了。
That's why my wife is coming soon。
没有愿意孤单吗
？Nobody wants to be by themselves.
那我们看夏甲，这个时候他被赶出家门呐、啊。
At this time, Hagar was pushed, forced out of her her household.
因为他受不了。
Because she could not stand it.
跑了。
So she fled.
但事实上是因为她受不了啊。
The reason is because she cannot bear it anymore.
就好像是被 abuse 一样。
Because she was being abused.
所以自己一个人跑了，又怀着身孕。
So she ran away by herself, and she was pregnant.
可是现在呢，她在旷野地啊，可能她在哭啊，没有诉苦的对象啊，自己对着天哈、啊、仰天而哭啊。
But now she was in the wilderness, and perhaps she was crying out loud to herself to the heavens.
这个时候呢，神就 跟她显现了。
At this time, God appeared to her.
啊，就出声音呐，对她说话。
And spoke to her.
然后她就觉得，哎，神也听见她的苦情哎。
And she felt that, God is listening to my cry.
她以为四边都没人。
She thought that she was alone by herself in the wilderness.
她以为她很孤单。
She thought she was alone.
她以为没有人会帮助她。
She thought that nobody would help her.
她以为没有人能够了解她。
She felt that nobody could understand her.
她以为她自己就注定啊，这一辈子就是要孤孤单单的走完这一生。
She thought that she was fated to finish her life alone in by herself.
她认为啊，她的孩子可能出生以后啊，一定会很可怜的。
She thought that once her child was born.He would live a very tough life.
可是现在神听他的声音。
But now God has listened to his voice.
就让他有信心。
So had boosted her faith.
让他觉得一种安慰。
So that she is comforted.
让他觉得不再孤单。
So that she felt no longer alone.
让他有勇气想再走完，再继续走完人生啊。
So that she has the courage to continue walking in this life.
他不再觉得孤单。
She no longer felt alone.
因为神听她的声音。
Because God had heard her voice.
所以神听我们声音的话，那会让我们觉得不再孤单呢。
So when God listens to our voice, we will feel that we are no longer alone.
因为神与我们同在呀。
Because God is with us.
所以我们不管走到哪里。
No matter where we walk to.
不管我们的环境怎么样。
No matter how our circumstances are in this world.
全世界不管有没有人喜欢我们。
Even if nobody in this world likes us.
这个都不是主要的。
These are not important.
主要只要有神与我们同在。
The most important thing is whether God is with us.
只要有神愿意听我们声音就够了。
If God is willing to listen to our voice, that is enough.
那就是一种极大的安慰。
And that is a great comfort.
再继续看创世纪。
Let's continue reading Genesis.
十七章。
Chapter 17.
创世纪二十一章。
Genesis 21.
二十一章十七节。
21 verse 17.
创世纪二十一章十七节。
Genesis chapter 21 verse 17.
神听见童子的声音，这个童子就是夏甲的孩子啊，那时候已经出生了。
And God heard the voice of the lad. The voice of the lad was Ishmael, because he was already born at the time.
那神就听到童子在哭的声音呢，神的使者从天上呼叫夏甲说：“夏甲，你为什么这样呢？不要害怕，神已经听见童子的声音。”十八节，
18.
起来，把童子抱在怀中，我必使他的后裔成为大国。十九节，
19.
神使夏甲的眼睛明亮，他就看见一口井，便去将皮带盛满的水给孩子喝。二十节。
20.
那神就保佑童子，他就渐渐长大，住在旷野，成了弓箭手。二十一，他住在巴兰的旷野，他母亲从埃及地给他娶了一个妻子。那这是夏甲的遭遇。
And this is the what happened to Hagar.
因为刚刚我们所看到那个故事的结局，就是神要他再回到他主人的家里。
Because the conclusion of the story we previously saw was that God wanted Hagar to return to her master's house.
啊，等待把孩子生出来。
To wait until the child was born.
孩子生出来以后，名字叫做以斯玛利。
And after the child was born, his name will be called Ishmael.
啊，以斯玛利就慢慢长大。
And Ishmael grew up.
啊，长大以后就跟亚伯拉罕自己所亲生的孩子啊，就撒拉的孩子啊，两个就有时候会争吵啊。
And after he grew up, Ishmael fought with Sarah's child, Sarah's own child, and they fought.
然后因为为了产业的问题。
And because of the issue of inheritance.
所以就是要请夏甲离开这个家。
So they ask Hagar to leave this home.
那离开以后啊，他走啊走啊，走到旷野的地方。
And after they left the home, they walked and walked into the wilderness.
那他们所携带的食物、水。都用完了。
And they had exhausted the food and water that they were carrying.
你看在旷野的地方嘿。
They were in the wilderness.
我们这边到撒迦勉度中间呢，有很多的旷野地呀。
between here and Sacramento, there are a lot of wilderness.
那更往东边走的话，那旷野地更多。
And if you go farther east, there are even more wilderness.
犹他州那边的旷野地也很多啊。
And there are a lot of wilderness in the state of Utah.
走到那里头了，四处无人。
If you walk over there, there's nobody around you.
没什么商店。
There are no shops.
很吓人的。
And it's very frightening.
那东西只要是在用完的话，那更恐怖。
And if you exhaust all your supplies, it is even more terrifying.
那真的会害怕起来的。
You'll start to fear.
所以夏甲也是让他的孩子啊，走到旷野的当中啊。
So Hagar was the same. With her boy, they were in the middle of the wilderness without anything.
啊，天气又热。
And it was hot.
又没水。
There's no water.
啊，这个时候怎么办呢？
This time, what do you do?
没办法啦，就是等死啊。
There's nothing you can do. You're just waiting for death.
啊，当时也没有手机打电话求救。
At that time, they didn't have cell phones to call for help.
也没有什么便利的商店。
And they didn't have convenience stores.
啊，所以怎么办呢？等死啊。
So what do you do? You just have to wait for death.
等死啊，人死了会害怕啊。
But when you're facing death, you will be afraid.
说夏甲也哭，他的孩子啊，哭得更大声啊。
So Hagar was weeping, and her child was weeping even more.
啊，两个母子啊，就一起哭啊。
So between the mother and son, both of them were crying.
结果神就听见童子的声音。
And God heard the voice of the lad.
然后就出声音了，对夏甲说。
And spoke out to Hagar.
说你不要害怕。
Fear not.
神已经听了声音了。
For God had heard the voice.
所以我们只要确定神听着我们声音以后。
So once we know that God has listened to us,
就是表示有救了啊。
It means that you have hope.
好像我们在旷野地方。
It's just like you're in the wilderness.
啊，出了事情。
And something happened.
要打911。
You call 911.
啊，911等人回答。
When 911 responds,
啊，就是表示有救了的。
It means that you have help.
也是有听到人的声音呢。
Because you have heard someone to assist you.
啊，假如都听不到什么声音。
If you cannot hear anything,
啊，就是电话还打不通。
And you can't even make the call.
要是没有车辆经过。
And there are no passing cars.
你看多么可怕。
How frightening would it be?
可是这时候呢，神出声音了。
But here God spoke.
说他就不会害怕了。
So that she would no longer fear.
所以神出声音，我们就不怕了。
So when God speaks, we are no longer afraid.
因为帮助就马上快到了。
Because help is on its way.
因为已经有回答了。
Because there's already a response.
所以神的声音就让我们不会害怕。
So God's voice will make us not be afraid.
所以神听我们声音是很大的恩典呢。
So for God to listen to our voice, to hear a voice, it is a tremendous blessing.
那第一个让我们不再觉得孤单。
First of all, it causes us to not feel lonely or alone.
啊，让我们得到安慰。
So that we may be comforted.
让我们得到力量。
So that we can gain strength.
我们不再害怕。
We will no longer be afraid.
那我们有勇气啊，再继续走下去的。
So that we have the courage to continue walking.
再继续站起来。
To stand up.
听到神声音后啊，这个夏甲就觉得啊，他们的生活有着落了。
After Hagar heard the voice of God, she felt that there is hope for her life.
所以她眼睛明亮，就看到一口水井。
So her eyes were open and she saw a well of water.
啊，一口水井就能够解决他们生活的问题呀。
Because a well of water can solve all their problems.
有水的话，人就能够生存了。
As long as there's water, a person can live.
所以就解决他们生存的问题。
So it solved the problem of survival.
所以神的恩典呢，第一个就是他听到我们的声音了。
So God's blessing is that first of all, God hears our voice.
我们有救了。
We have help.
那第二个呢
？Second.
我们再请看回到诗篇的一百十六篇。
Let's turn back to Psalm number 116.
诗篇一百十六篇。
Psalm number 116.
第六节。
Verse 6.
神保护愚人，我落到卑微的地步，他救了我。
The Lord preserves the simple. I was brought low, and He saved me.
说神保护愚人。
So God, the Lord preserves the simple.
那第二个恩典呢，就是神保护我们呢。
The second blessing is that God would save us.
愚人呢，就是单纯的人呢。
And the simple, it's someone who is simple-minded.
因为太复杂的话，这个脑筋想太多了。
Because if they are complex characters, then they would think too much.
这个脑筋想太多的话，对神的话会产生怀疑。
If you think too much, you will have doubt against God.
因为他说啊，这个信不下去的。
And they might say, I cannot believe this.
圣经所谈论的这好像是一个历史。
And what the Bible describes is a, seems like a history.
圣经所谈的好像是一部小说，一部文学。
Or the Bible is like a novel, or it is like a literature, a literary piece.
可以读。
You can read it.
但是不能信。
But I can't believe it.
因为觉得只是普通的小说，普通历史而已的。
Because it is full of stories, or it is a historical book.
就是神怎么创造。
Even how God created the heavens and the earth.
耶稣基督怎么救人。
And how Jesus died for our sins.
怎么行神迹。
And how miracles are performed.
这个是过去的事情。
These are things of the past.
也是一个以前的故事。
And also stories of the old.
可是简单的人呢，他就会相信了。
But a simple person would believe.
神就拯救这些简单的人。
And God is one who saves and delivers the simple.
信心单纯的人。
Those who have simple faith,
神就保护他们了。
God will protect them.
那保护呢？叫部分二十四个小时都在保护。
And the protection will be there 24/7, on all at all times.
晚上也保护，白天也保护。
At night and during the day.
在危险的时候，他还保护我们。
In times of danger, He protects us.
我们很多人有这种体验呢。
Many people have this experience.
在危险的时候。
In times of danger.
有在车祸的时候，神保守。
Or in times of car accidents, God will protect them.
以前我还没当传道，做生意要去参加一个电脑的展览。
And before I was a pastor, when I had to go to a computer exhibition.
那就开车开到这个高速公路上。
So I was driving and I was going on the highway.
那个时候天气下着毛毛的细雨。
And at that time there was light rain.
忽然之间我的车就打滑。
And suddenly I lost control of the car.
车子失去控制。
So the car was slipping.
车子在高速公路上蛇行这样子。
So I was swerving on the highway.
就好像那 Jeep 就这样一个 Jeep 这样子行
走。So I was zigzagging on the road.
感谢主那个时候后面没有来车。
But thankfully, there were no other cars in the behind me.
哇，真是吓死了！那个时候真是慌了的。
At that time, I was so afraid because I was panicking.
因为方向盘失去了控制。
Because I could no longer control the car with my steering wheel.
哇，在紧急的时候在慌张的时候就喊三次哈利路亚。
And that at that urgent time when I was panicking, I shouted Hallelujah three times.
结果呢，很奇妙车子就很平稳的停在路肩上。
And very miraculously, the car came to a stop at the shoulder.
因为我对方向盘失去控制，也不能够做什么。
Because I had lost control of the car, I could not do anything.
那时候速度很快。
And at that time, I was driving very fast.
可是车子很奇妙能够停下来。
But miraculously, the car was able to stop.
在短距离之内就能够停下来。
And it was able to stop in a very short distance.
而且是停对的方向。
And it was facing the right direction.
那后来就下车查看。
And I got off the car to inspect.
后面的车子就一直来了。
And cars behind me started passing by.
所以我就不敢离开车子，就坐在座位上等待警察来帮忙。
So I did not dare to leave the car. I was waiting for the police to come and assist me.
那不一会儿警察就来了。
And after a while, the police came.
就来解决我们问题。
And to solve our problem.
那还有一次我那时候在负担凤凰城教会的时候。
And there was another time I was overseeing Phoenix Church.
开车从凤凰城要到南加州。
And I was driving from Phoenix to Southern California.
那个路有很多是旷野路。
And there were a lot of roads that were in the wilderness.
那有一次还没下站休息以前我太太坐在我旁边。
And there was one time before I came to a rest stop, my wife was sitting next to me.
那我太太就说：“这个车子怎么怪怪，怎么一直颤抖了？”
And my wife was saying, "How come this car is behaving so strange? How come it's shaking like this?"
那我说可能这个车子性能，因为这个是比较高的车子，又是什么四轮的什么四轮带动那个很重的车子。
And I said, "Well, maybe cars like this just drive like this because it was a four wheel drive and it was a bigger car."
因为在高速公路上，它也是那个路很平它也是就是很会抖。
Because even though it was on the highway and the road was very smooth, But the car was shaking like this.
那我太太说啊，可能有问题。
So my wife said, maybe there's something wrong.
我安慰她说，可能不会吧，这个可能是这个车子的性能就是这样子的。
And I comfort her and saying, perhaps not. Maybe it's just that these type of cars drive like this.
好，那我们就啊到了一个出口去加油。
So we went to a gas station to get some gas.
那加油的时候有个先生啊，有个先生他就向我们走过来呀。
And when we were getting gas, there was a man who walked towards us.
他说啊，你的轮胎啊已经快爆胎了。
And he told us, oh, your tire is about to explode.
你要赶快换呐。
You're about to have a flat tire, so you need to.
不然等一下那个路段啊，这样上上下下很危险的。
Otherwise, it's very dangerous when you start going over the hills.
要感谢主啊，我就赶快哈打个电话问负责人说能不能换啊？他说可以，然后说。赶快，在那个加油站的修车厂就换了。
And thankfully, I made a call to the church council members and said, "Oh, can I replace this?" And they said yes. So I was able to get it fixed right there at the gas station.
那很奇妙，他当时为什么会走向我们
？And it's very miraculous how he was able to. This man was able to walk towards us.
我们才刚停下不久嘞。
Because we had just stopped not too long.
停车又就马上加油。
And we stopped and we immediately got gas.
油还没加满呢，他就来了。
Before the tank was filled, this man walked over.
说神真的会保护我们呢。
So God will truly protect us.
这是极大的恩典。
And this is a great grace.
那第三个。
The third.
来看116篇。
Let's turn to Psalm number 116.
第八节。
Verse 8.
主啊，你救我的命，免了死亡；救我的眼啊，免了流泪；救我的脚。
For you have delivered my soul from death, my eyes from tears, and my feet from falling.
我们看这边提到啊，说三个免了，免了，免了。
And here we see how God had delivered him from three things.
啊，怎么救我们的命呢
？How does he deliver our soul?
免了死亡。
Delivered the soul from death.
当然，有些时候神会在危险当中救我们脱离死亡。
Of course, many times in times of danger, God will deliver our physical lives from death.
啊，脱离肉体的死亡。
And this is the physical death.
啊，但是呢，有一天还是会再死的。
But one day we will still die.
啊，人呢不能够永远活着。
Because man cannot live forever.
但是最主要是呢，救我们脱离那个永远的死。
But more importantly, God is here to deliver our souls from the eternal death.
啊，那才是最重要的了。
That is the most important.
因为根据圣经说啊，人死后有审判呢。
Because according to the Bible, after we die, there is a judgment.
那没信耶稣的人就受定罪。
And those who are unbelievers will be judged.
信耶稣的人啊，就是到了天堂。
And those who are believers will not be condemned but go to heaven.
那不信的话，就是要到死亡里头啊。
And if you have unbelief, you will go to be eternally dead.
啊，那个死亡啊，不是说好像死了一死白了啦，死了就什么都不知道了。
And this type of death is not the one who you say, oh, it's just like being asleep and everything is end, the end right there.
啊，大家都做过这个噩梦的经验哈。
And perhaps everyone has this type of nightmare.
啊，噩梦很吓人的。
And nightmares are very frightening.
可是你一醒过来以后，你就拍拍肩膀说，拍拍胸膛说，哎呀，好在啊是噩梦呢，不是真的。
When we wake up, we will feel relieved and say, "A good thing that was just a dream."
啊，可能啊，你已经啊，满头大汗啊，吓得很呢。
Perhaps you have been frightened so that you actually are perspiring all over.
啊，有个弟兄他半夜啊三点的时候做噩梦。
There was a brother who had a nightmare, and he woke up at 3 a.m.
他梦到地狱呀。
And he had dreamed that he was in hell.
他吓到发抖。
And he was so shooken up that he was shivering.
整个床铺在他抖啊。
The entire bed was shaking.
抖到他太太也醒了。
He was shaking so much that he woke his wife.
所以是很吓人的。
So it is very frightening.
那这个死亡是什么样子呢
？But what is this death like?
我们请看《帖撒罗尼迦后书》。
Let's turn to Second Thessalonians.
帖撒罗尼迦后书第一章。
Second Thessalonians chapter 1,
第八节
verse 8.
帖撒罗尼迦后书第一章第八节
Second Thessalonians chapter 1, verse 8.
要报应那不认识神和那不听从我主耶稣福音的人啊，第九节
verse 9.
怎么报应呢？说他们要受刑罚， 就是永远沉沦离开主的面和他全能的荣光。
In flaming fire, take vengeance on those who do not know God and those who do not obey the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. These shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of the Lord and from the glory of his power.
啊，这是不听福音的人呢。
So those who do not listen to the gospel.
啊，要永远沉沦。
And they will be punished eternally.
啊，沉沦就是到一个深渊呢，爬不起来的。
And this everlasting destruction will be, they can never come out of it.
说离开主的面和他全能的荣光。
And those who have departed from the presence of the Lord and the glory of His power.
所以沉沦的人呢，就是进入到永远的黑暗里头了。
So those who are punished with everlasting destruction, is to enter into eternal darkness.
因为没有光啊。
Because there is no light.
我们在这个文明的社会当中啊。
And in this civilized life we live in.
科技很发达。
Its technology is very advanced.
我电力充足。
And there's a lot of electricity.
我们不会有停电的烦恼。
And we don't have the problem of losing power.
啊，就是晚上停电可能是一个小时而已的。
And even if we lose power, it's probably an hour during the middle of the night.
甚至于可能少于一个小时啊，电力就恢复了。
Or it's just less than an hour and power is restored.
啊，可是，在有些国家不一样啊。
In some countries, it is not so.
啊，整个晚上都没电呢。
The entire night, there will be no electricity.
啊，有些这电可能要停了两三天呢。
And some people, some countries, they will lose power for 2-3 days.
那没有电很不方便呢。
If you don't have electricity, it's very inconvenient.
啊，假设再没有蜡烛的话，哇，那晚上更不方便。
And if you don't have any candles, it's very inconvenient during the middle of the night.
啊，有一次我到非洲去。协助圣工的时候
，One time I went to Africa to assist the holy work there.
有一天晚上啊，到了一个信徒家里的家庭聚会。
One night we went to a member's house for a Bible study.
没有电灯。
And there was no electricity.
啊，新的房子哦，新的房子没有电灯。
It's a brand new house, but there was no electricity.
所以我们都在外面聚会。
So we had service outside.
啊，天很黑呀。
It was very dark.
所以看不清楚谁是谁。
So you cannot tell who was who.
啊，用手电筒照着圣经呢。
So you had to use a flashlight to shine on the Bible.
所以很不方便呢。
It was very inconvenient.
那个是看不清楚谁是谁的。
But you cannot tell who is around you.
啊，当然了，我们忍一忍哈，到了早上哈，就可以看到太阳光啊。
And all we have to do is endure until the morning hours, and then we can have the sunlight.
可是，只要是沉沦的话，是永远的黑暗。
But if you are have fallen into everlasting destruction.Then it will be eternal darkness.
那没有机会再看到太阳光。
You will never have an opportunity to see daylight.
可是我们信耶稣以后呢
？But after we have believed in Christ,
我们就免了死亡。
We have been saved from this death.
就免了黑暗。
We are saved from this darkness.
我们可以进到神的荣光里头。
We can enter into the glorious light of God.
说这个是不是神极大的恩典呢
？So isn't this a tremendous grace of God?
你不相信的话，你现在可以把眼睛闭起来。
If you don't believe, you can close your eyes right now.
一直闭到啊，你要回。回家，下午的时候要回家。
Keep your eyes closed until you have to go home and this afternoon.
啊，你都看不到什么东西啊。
And you cannot see anything.
啊，到底感觉怎么样
？How would that feel?
啊，这个以后就是永远的啊。
And in the future, that would be eternal.
好，我们再看啊，再另外一个描写。
Let's look at another description.
马可福音第九章。
Mark chapter 9.
马可福音第九章。
Mark chapter 9.
马可福音第九章，我们看48节。
Mark chapter 9 verse 48。
47节哈，最后一句话说丢在地狱里啊，丢在地狱里啊，九章四十七。
Last latter phrase of verse 47 says to be cast into hellfire。
好，那48节就形容说地狱是什么样子的。
And 48 describes what hell is like.
在那里，虫是不死的，火是不灭的。
Where their worms does not die and the fire is not quenched.
这个虫都很吓人的。
And worms are quite frightening.
啊，不是一只虫啊。
It's not just one worm.
啊，不是您所喜爱的那个小动物的虫。
It's not like the worms that you like, the little animals.
啊，虫是很多啊，爬在身上。
But many worms and they will be climbing all over your body.
几千只、几万只啊。
Thousands or ten thousands.
啊，怕不怕
？Would you be afraid?
啊，不怕的请举手。
If you are not afraid, please raise your hand.
哎，我看在男生也会怕。
And I believe that even boys will be afraid.
好，那这个火啊是不灭的。
And this fire is not quenched.
所以那个死亡是多么的痛苦啊。
So this death is so painful.
啊，可是现在我们因为信耶稣啊。
But now because we believe in Christ.
我们在免的啊。
We have been saved from all this.
来免的死亡啊。
We have been delivered from this.
好，那第二个是免的眼泪。
And the second is that we are delivered from tears.
那眼泪当然伤心的时候会掉眼泪的。
Of course, when we have sorrow, we will shed tears.
啊，大家有没有哭过啊？
Have you cried before?
有没有哭过超过五分钟的？
Have you ever cried more than 5 minutes?
啊，不好意思，让大家举手，这个哭不好意思。
And it's perhaps it's not comfortable for people to raise your hands.
这一辈子没有哭过的，没有掉过眼泪的，请举手。
But if you have never shed tears in your entire life, please raise your hand.
哎，那就是大家都有啊。
So that means that everyone has.
所以眼泪一直流很辛苦啊。
It's very tiring for you to keep on shedding tears.
那圣经说啊，眼泪流多了会变成干杯啊，会有病的。
And the Bible says that
很干呢、啊。
If you keep on the tears keep on flowing, it will become a very bitter cup.
你看伤心事啊，会让我们掉眼泪。
And very sorrowful things will cause us to shed tears.
啊，眼泪流多了就会很干啊，眼睛很干的。
And when we shed so much tears, our eyes will be dry.
啊，流了再多的话，眼睛会有毛病的。
And you keep on shedding tears, you'll have eye problems.
所以很辛苦啊。
It's very tough.
可是现在信耶稣以后，
But now we have a belief in Christ.
我们不用再掉眼泪了。
We no longer need to shed tears.
我们掉眼泪是喜乐的眼泪。
We only shed tears of joy.
啊，请看启示录。
Let's turn to Revelation.
启示录二十一章。
Revelation chapter 21.
第四节。
Verse 4.
启示录二十一章第四节。
Revelation chapter 21 verse 4.
第四。
Verse 4.
神要擦去他们一切的眼泪、啊、不再有死亡，也不再有悲哀、哭嚎、疼痛。人为什么会流眼泪？因为有死亡，有悲哀、疼痛。
And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death, no nor sorrow, no crying. So why do people shed tears? It's because of this death, sorrow, and pain.、
啊、就是因为有这些，我们才会掉眼泪呀、啊。
Because we have these things, that is why we shed tears.
啊，现在神要擦去我们的眼泪。
But now God will wipe away every tear.
我们不会再流眼泪了。
We will no longer shed tears.
因为不再有死亡。
Because there shall be no more death.
不再有疼痛。
Nor pain.
我们不会再受伤害。
Nor will we have sorrow.
因为我们都更新了。
Because we have been renewed.
我们再没有敌人了。
We will not have any enemies.
而且敌人已经被我们控制了。
Because the enemy has been controlled.
所以我们就很轻松了。
So we are very at ease.
没有死亡啊，没有悲哀了。
There's no death, no sorrow.
神要擦去我们一切眼泪。
And God will wipe away every tear.
所以你看，免于眼泪呀。
So we have been delivered from our
tears. 那这是不是一个极大恩典呢
？Is this not a tremendous grace?
我们还要说免于跌倒。
And also, we have been delivered so that we would not fall.
那跌倒就是一种失败呀。
To fall is to have a failure.
啊，有些人就要推我们跌倒嘞。
Some people would push us so that we fall.
好像大卫说，有人要 push 他跌倒啊。
It's just like how David says there are those that were
是故意的。
Shove them so that they would fall. They do this intentionally.
啊，让他起不来。
So that they cannot stand up.
可是人的陷害呢，神有办法来救他。
But the traps of man, God can deliver us from.
圣经说啊，神爱我们啊，没有一个事情能够跟把我们跟神之间的爱隔绝。
Because the Bible tells us that there's nothing that can separate us from the love of God.
神不会让我们跌倒的。
God will not cause us to fall.
就是我们失败的。
Even when we fail.
神会让我们再站起来。
God will cause us to so that we can stand up again.
所以我们不要怕失败。
So that let us not be afraid of failure.
每一个人都会失败过的。
Everybody will fail.
失败就是一个转机。
Because failure is a turning point.
失败就是一个恩典的来临。
And failure is an opportunity for grace.
所以我们要相信啊。
So we have to believe.
因为神说要救我们的命。
Because God says that He will deliver us from our lives.
免于死亡。
So that deliver us from death.
免于眼泪，免于跌倒。
Deliver us from tears and from falling.
所以你说神给我们的恩典多不多啊
？So don't you agree that God has given us such grace?
好，那现在问题啊，我们要怎么来回报主的恩典
？So now the question is, how shall we repay God's love?
我们请看回来诗篇一百十六篇。
Let's read Psalm number 116. And I wonder if you have any reflections upon the grace of God so far.
12.
So the psalmist declares, what shall I render to the Lord for all his benefits toward me?
13节.
13.
他说我要举起救恩的杯要称扬神的名14节 我要在他众人众民的面前向神还我的愿
I will take up the cup of salvation and call upon the name of the Lord. I will pay my vows to the Lord and in the presence of all his people.
第一个他说要举起救恩的杯啊
First he says I will take up the cup of salvation.
我们举杯做什么?
Why do we lift up this cup?
朋友在一起吃饭的时候
When you're eating with friends,
大家有时候会杯子说来来去一去啊，这样子碰一碰啊，杯子碰一碰。
You'll lift up your cup and say cheer, and then you'll clink your glass with other cups.
那为什么要说cheer呢？
And why would you say this?
因为大家很高兴啊，朋友在一起呀。
Because everybody is very joyful and they are together.
啊，所以叫cheer。那举杯就说要高兴啊。
So that is why they lift up their cup to cheer.
啊，举起救恩的杯。
And that is why you lift up the cup of salvation. God has delivered us from death. So when we are believers, we are very joyful. We can live a very joyful life.
And
God wants us to live a very joyful life. Don't come to church with full of sorrow. When we come, we have a lot of joy. We're filled with gratitude. So at church, you should not hear all the voice of complaint. God has given us so many graces and blessings. How do we even have time to complain? Do we have this joy?
怎么喜乐?
How do you have joy?
怎么喜乐起来啊?
How do you rejoice?
好, 我们来看圣经,
Let's turn to the Bible.
啊, 第一个啊, 来看使徒行传,
Let's turn to the book of Acts.
13章,
13.
啊, 14章,
chapter 14.
使徒行传14章的16节,
Acts chapter 14, verse 16.
他就在神啊，神在从前的世代任凭各万国啊各行其道17节。17。然而为自己啊，未尝不显出证据来，就如啊，常施恩惠，从天降雨，赏赐丰年，叫你们饮食饱足，满心喜乐。
When bygone generations allowed all nations to walk in their own ways, nevertheless he did not leave himself without witness, so that he did good, give us rain from heaven and fruitful seasons, filling our hearts with food and gladness.
好，所以你看有好吃的东西就要吃啊。
So when there's good food, you should eat.
就不用客气啊。
Don't be afraid.
因为神要我们饮食满足。
Because God wanted to be have abundance of food.
啊，吃的。 填饱肚子,
so that we can fill our stomachs.
啊, 我们就很高兴啊,
and then we will be very joyful.
啊, 我们就安慰我们的身体, 安慰我们肚子,
it will comfort our stomachs and,
啊, 这些顿饭吃得很好, 啊,
and comforts our bodies so that we can say this was a good meal.
啊, 我看这个有几个年轻弟兄啊, 在厨房里面已经在忙了。
And I see that there are some young brothers who are busy in the kitchen.
所以我们中午啊, 就不要客气, 啊, 要吃到饱, 啊,
So during lunch, we should not be hesitant and fill ourselves with good food.
反正安慰我们肚子, 哎呀, 感谢主, 真的吃得很饱啊。
And then it will bring comfort to our stomachs and we can thank the Lord for
心满意足,
giving us so that we can have such a wonderful meal.
所以我们是不是每一餐都是饮食饱足啊?
Do we have an abundant meal every meal?
所以不用